Hey there, everyone. My name is Trifium, and welcome to the Champions Division Highlights. We are here for the debut of the Champions Division, and it is Bahrain. What a thrilling campaign, and of course, we hope you enjoy the highlights.
Hey, that's just a little bit too far. We'll see. The 124-1, definitely within the McLaren's grasp here, and potential as Valley crosses. It's a 124 flat, just about stepping under the 124-1, an incredible lap.
Well,
here we go. We've got four or five red lights here on in Bahrain for the last time this week, and it's lights out, and away we go for the first time here for the Misfits Championship Division. It's a great start for Camille, who instantly puts himself side by side with Louis down into turn one. Later on the brakes there for the Mercedes, who's got the other Red Bull of Valu looking in his rear. Further back, there's still a lot of jostling for positions. Lucas already up four places in the Haas, up into 11th place. The front eight haven't changed at all. Thomas Harvey has found ninth. From Alpha's Kaya there in the Alpine, who's looking to come around the outside. It's a bit of a tussle in turn four as Valu makes up two places. Tomek drops to Risky for lead. Risky on the socks, finding a gap through on the inside of turn six to take those advantage of those socks. As there's a problem for Piotr, he started all the way up in the top 10, now 13 places down in 19th. There's a huge problem for him. Alpha's Kaya is dropping. He's down two places into 11th, outside of the points here. Luca, a great start from him, six places. Alpha's Kaya drops again.
Luca, oh, there's contact!
And the Alpine's around! That is
No.
A full 360, a brilliant save.
Scale anyway, get on, coming out of 13. There's been a huge collision. He's spun and Paris has gone into him. The McLaren and the Ferrari have come together.
He seems to be quite comfortable here. He goes up the inside, maybe later on the brakes into turn four. It's a brilliant move. Tomek gonna have a little look for the switchback if it opens itself, but not gonna fight the position too hard. He knows that his tire strategy is different. Switchback again, Thomas looking on the inside as Boggin has a problem. A little bit of a snap there from the Aston Martin, and that's gonna open the door for Milan. You don't have to ask the Ferrari twice. He's gonna make it side by side through sector two here, but the mediums, they are starting to come into their own, and Boggin able to defend P5 from Milan. It's costing time to Louis ahead, and it's broken the DRS train. This is a great opportunity. Podium later on in the race. There goes. But Camille pitting very early in the Red Bull. The Williams of Thomas Harvey looking on the inside of Milan. We saw him try this last lap around. We didn't have any chance there, but Milan just losing out. Gonna draft off of him just to get a bit more straight line speed, but it's not gonna do anything against Luke Smith, who's gonna breeze by the Haas in the AlphaTauri down towards turn one. Great move there from him. Tires, they want to keep their strategy going so that they can get on a pit stop in the optimal position. There goes Louis, getting back up into P2. There's a little bit of a glitch there. Luke Smith and Boggin, they are fighting side by side down into turn one, and there we go. Like I said, it is opening up now for a little bit more battles, and Luke Smith taking advantage of that. Risky in 127, five fastest lap of the race. Boggin not look like he's gonna have any response down into turn four, but the
Luca,
he just tried it on the inside a little bit too late. Oh, when he gets tapped as
in
the wrong place. The Haas has been spun around into the path of get over.
That is not what you want to see.
Is leading this race, and the other just unfortunately getting a car tapped, spun around into him. There is ahead. The Red Bull is going to be side by side with the McLaren, who's on the inside on the fresh sauce. They're not up to temperature. The Haas on the inside. Camille just losing out on traction as they go side by side through three. But it is the McLaren with the RS just sneaking ahead of the Red Bull. Tomek, he's got a long way to go in this race.
Carter Lundy and Brownie, is it ever tight between these two into turn four? Are they ever getting loose right now? Who's that on the inside? It's Rainbow pushing through. There's big contact. And oh my, I'm not sure what to say about all of that. Less than 2 tenths. About to drop beneath the tenth as he sends it up the inside. Gradually breaking here, just trying to hold with Camille. There's a bit of a shuffle here as he looks and steps his toe in on the inside. Camille. There goes any gap that he had to Thomas, and that's just giving Thomas some breathing space. I don't know what to say.
Well, the Ferrari is vulnerable, and if he doesn't push the move, here we go, already on the ERS, down towards turn one. Milan's got DRS, but it doesn't matter at all. The Mercedes is just going to steam by, but watch for the AlphaTauri behind. Can he find a way through as well? Luke Smith later on the brakes, just a little lighter on it.
Oh.
Louis, well, he's just got a bit too heavy into turn one. slams into Camille with the side of his car. Behind them, the Aston Martin of Boggin. He's looking to get a piece of the action here. He's got eyes of four cars, three of them going three wide. Louis getting pinched by Luke Smith on the inside. What an excellent move from the AlphaTauri. Louis slots into sixth ahead of Camille, and Boggin gets Milan. These soft runners are tearing the mid-pack apart. And Camille and Milan are losing a big time.
Oh, inside of turn eight, Aston Martin says hello to Ferrari, and that's Piotr Staciolak moving through for this Aston Martin. However, on the outside, Modesto's there as well. There's contact. Camille's round. Milan, a hair separating him and Camille as he drove by there. Does Risky have an opportunity to defend this? Well, we've talked about DRS, and I have to say, it's not going to be easy if he tries, and, well, there's not much he can try right now. Tomek into lead of this race, pushing for an inside overtake here on Luke, and it's going to be a gradual, easy move with that DRS in full utilization.
Looking at Piotr here, down into turn one, the Alpine Reserve, looking at the Aston Martin very hungrily. He's on the inside. They're still side by side here, pushing the Aston Martin a little wide as they go through into turn two. Now he is ahead. Shouldn't be too much of an issue. But it's a huge lunge coming up on the other Aston Martin. Boggin on the inside for the Williams of Thomas. And Thomas on these old mediums just has no defense as well. But Tomek crosses onto the final lap of the race. 29 of 29. It's been almost 2 hours since we started things. And now, only now, is P3 going to be decided. Valu under pressure. His lights sprinkling on the rear of that Red Bull. He's looking to defend the outside. Louis switches to the inside. The Mercedes is up there. It's late on the brakes, though. Is it too late? Does it open the door for the AlphaTauri? Is he going to go for the switchback here? Through turn three into the DRS. So that's turn four. He gets the Red Bull. He won't quite have the speed to get the Mercedes as well, but he is up into P4. They both dispatched the medium runner. There's been a problem behind. Thomas Harvey and Boggin are in the wall. What's happened here between the two drivers? The medium runner and the soft runner have come together. There's been problems for Boggin in the closing stages, and now it's all accumulated in a last lap crash. But my goodness, Luke Smith, who's going to come out on top here? 4P3, they've got Risky as well, because he's now just a second ahead. I think it's too late for them.
Milan has a puncture, that front left tire. I don't know if someone went into him, but that front left tire is in a state of its own. Oh my, and this race has really been unleashed here in the final stages as Lewis is into third, Luke Smith fourth. What's happened? Lewis Welch, no, he has just slid through turn 13. Oh my days, Tomek is coming into the final two turns now. Wait a minute, Tomek's front left is punctured. Tomek's front left is punctured. Risky, what's happened to him? He's coming out wide. Luke Smith is going to go ahead of Risky here to the line. Tomek will take the race win in Bahrain. Luke Smith to the line will take second. His teammate Risky behind him. Valu in fourth. What a race finish here in Bahrain. I have no words to describe some of the scenarios that just unfolded right there with Modesto Mena fifth position. It was Lewis who will finally cross this line.
The final corner strip as well.
I don't know.
So is the Aston Martin. It's punctures all round. I said it was early to go onto the softs when they all did it. And now it seems they're paying the price of that. The Haas is losing a rear left. The Ferrari behind is missing the front left.
What a thrilling race for the Champions Division action, of course. What an explosive final lap there, of course. And so many punctures, so many issues for these racers. Who knew who was going to finish where there? Tomek, fortunately, securing the win on three wheels. So we'll have to see how things go in the Netherlands. See you in the next one.